Oak Hill in 1995 was the second victory overseas for Team Europe, and what a victory it was. Facing the singles 2 points behind, Nick Faldo and rookie Philip Walton wouldn't take no for an answer. When Di Reese and Britain took on Team USA at the Lindrick Golf Club in 1957, all bets were off as the Americans held a 3-1 lead on the Friday. Until Britain stormed through the singles matches to win the required 6.5 points. That was the first British victory since 1933. From recent 57 to Tony Jacklin in 1985, who led Team Europe to success. That was made possible by stunning play from Bernard Langer and Sam Torrance. Europe were finally able to claim the much-coveted trophy at the Belgrade.
Have a good feeling about this.
Brookline in 1999 will forever be known as the year of destiny for Ben Crenshaw and Team USA. Left 4 points behind from a dismal Friday and Saturday, they made a return that was surely a sight to be seen.
They believed in themselves. They knew how close these matches were, despite some fantastic play by the Europeans, but today, I tell you, it's up in the tree. It's fate.
Whether you call it the meltdown or the miracle, Medina in 2012 was an edge-of-your-seat spectacle. With the help of German Martin Keimer and blessings from the late Seve Ballesteros, José María Olazabal led Team Europe into the golfing history books.
To the 12 men of Team Europe, you believe and you deliver. All men die, not all men live. And you made me feel alive once again this week.